Rescues are our favorite breed of dog. My mom really wants a small dog that she can get fit with, but I really want a bulldog that is slobbery and I can cuddle with. Clearly, there's still a lot of research we need to do to find the right puppy for our family.
Getting a puppy can be a very exciting experience for many people. So one of the most important things that I want to tell people is that choosing the right puppy for you and your family is really important. Often people pick a puppy and they don't take into consideration what is the nature of that breed. Is it suitable for the lifestyle that they're living? If they're living in a condo, is this a dog that was primarily bred to herd sheep? They have to be picking something that's going to be suitable for their lifestyle now, not something that they have in their mind as a dream.
My boyfriend and I chose a Golden Doodle because we have known a few different Golden Doodles and they are a fantastic breed. We definitely did do our research. Every dog and every breed has a lifestyle that they will best fit in.
There's a lot of evidence which talks about the fact that people are happiest if they select a dog which is appropriate for their personality. When I'm considering what my next breed of dog is going to be, and I look at a whole lot of adult dogs, because that's going to tell you what the dog's behavior is going to be like and that sort of thing. And remember, your dog's going to be an adult for a long time. He's going to be that puppy for 4 to 6 months. I wrote a book called Why We Love the Dogs We Do, which is based on a huge study. I mean, we looked at over 6,000 people. But there seems to be a couple of little rules of thumb. You should not pick a dog simply because the dog's in the media.
I think people are a little disillusioned when they get a Chihuahua. They think they're looking for a dog to carry around in your purse. What people don't necessarily realize is Chihuahuas are just like any other dog. Whether they're 2 pounds, 3 pounds, or 6 pounds, if you don't train them, if you don't socialize them properly, you're going to run into issues.
So one of the things people really have to do is they really have to at least do some minimal amount of reading about the particular breeds of dogs.
So different breeds have different issues. We know, for example, in Golden Retrievers or Lab Retrievers, or certainly in German Shepherds, we may see hip dysplasia as an issue. But we know that with good breeding and with what a lot of breeders have done, they've tried to do a great job at trying to decrease those inherent risks. In terms of bulldogs that have more of a squishy face, we may notice more breathing or respiratory issues specifically with them, but not necessarily anything that usually would require surgical correction. So just because they are a bulldog doesn't automatically mean that they will have a problem with respect to breathing or something along those lines.
The other things that you want to look for when you're picking up a puppy, of course, is, you know, what type of time you have for the puppy. So if you don't have a lot of time to be dedicated to long walks in the forest or training exercises and frisbee and that sort of thing, you shouldn't be picking a dog that is going to need that type of activity.
So Remy, at 8 weeks old, I met him and I was looking for a busy companion because I like to do agility, I like to do dog sports.
Tannum's a very playful dog. These dogs need a lot of exercise. They're full of energy. They just love to play with toys all the time. They're just a wonderful breed.
The cost of ownership, of course, is incredibly important to consider. So providing medical care, food, you know, all of the little things we love to give our pets is a cost that we need to be able to take into account and budget for and know that we're capable of managing on an ongoing basis.
Even if you want a brand new puppy as cute as this one, only 8 weeks old, 9 weeks old when they come home from the litter, there are rescue options for this. Many times shelters and other rescue organizations will take in dogs that are actually expecting. So it is possible to adopt and save a life of an 8 or 9 week old dog and still get the puppyhood experience. So don't rule out rescue just because you want a young 8 or 9 week old puppy. If you're gonna look at breeders, look for breeders that belong to reputable organizations like the Canadian Kennel Club. I would definitely look for breeders that are willing to let you come visit their home or their breeding facility. I do suggest meeting the mom and dad of the litter if possible.
Not only you need to pick the right breed, pick the right breeder and a good source, someone who's going to raise your puppy from 0 to 8 weeks in the best possible fashion. You want one that's been handled by the breeder, that's been introduced to novel stimuli from the time that its eyes are open, so that you'll have a puppy that's going to be well adjusted to your family and your children, grandchildren, and neighbors.
It's also important that if you're meeting a breeder, that you ask them, have they had issues with their particular dogs, with their line, with that breed? Have they seen any problems with respect to anything specifically? And most breeders are very honest. They'll also show you some of the genetic testing that they've done to try and outbreed some of these problems within their particular dogs.
We found the breeder online and we had reached out to a couple of the previous dog owners. We had seen a lot of pictures, we had visited the farm where they are bred. They only do 1 to 2 litters per year, so it's very limited. That's something you really need to look out for. If a breeder is pumping out 5 to 10 litters a year, it's probably going to be a red flag.
I'm a director of Helping Homeless Pets and of Tiny Paws Dog Rescue. Just look at where the dogs are coming from. You know, when you get a dog from a pet store, look, you know, be responsible. You know, check out, can you see the mother, father? You know, there are responsible breeders out there, but you need to do your research. If they won't let you see the mother and father and where the litters come from, really stop and think. You know, on Kijiji, if they meet you in a parking lot, then really stop and think, okay, where is that dog coming from? And that's what we ask for people to do.